now we will call on this apply. Then we will plug in DP3A to L1 and switch to 25%. CP1 close, CP2 close, and then switch to close. Then we set this. We will take this reading for supply voltage and this is the load voltage. Next, we will switch the resisting load to 50%. And then we will take this reading for voltage, supply voltage, and load voltage. Next to 75%. Same procedure, just take this reading, and same goes for 100% for the resisting voltage. This reading, this reading. Now continue with experiment one, procedure B, and we'll disconnect this and connect the TP3 together and connect this TP4A to resistive load. Then we go to 25% and we switch CV1 to close and transition close. And we take the reading here, this is the supply voltage, this is the load voltage. And then we'll repeat the procedure with 25%, 50%, 75%, and 100%. And next, we'll go to experiment 2. Experiment 2, we just have to disconnect this resistive load to inductive load. And take the reading, supply voltage is here. And this is the load voltage, the inductive load voltage. Then we will switch from 25. And take the reading over here from 25, 50, 75, and 100. Next, we'll do the experiment 3. Experiment 3 is basically the ring connection. So first, we'll do this to here, and then we'll just connect this. So first we will take the no load voltage. No load voltage is basically this one. This is no load voltage. And for the first part, we'll connect here to the resistive load. And for the same, we'll just take the reading. This is the supply voltage and this is the load voltage from 25% to 50, 75, 100. And next we'll repeat the process from resistive load to inductive load, and we'll take the reading from 25%. This is the voltage, supply voltage, this is the load voltage, and 25, 50, 75, 100. And then lastly is the capacitive load. You just connect to the capacitive load and take the reading from 25%, and this is the supply voltage, load voltage, 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%. That's all for the experiment.